everyone. Today we'll be reviewing the national flag of Papua New Guinea. The review will be done using the five basic principles of flag design as outlined in the book Good Flag, Bad Flag, written by Ted Kay and published by the North American Vexillological Association. Here is a quick rundown of the five principles. We will review the flag under each principle and give a score out of 10 for each. At the end, we will calculate the average score of the five principles, which will give us the overall final score for the flag. Let's begin. The flag is divided diagonally from the upper hoist to the lower fly, forming two triangles. The upper triangle is red and the lower triangle is black. The red triangle is charged with a yellow stylized depiction of a bird of paradise. The black triangle is charged with a depiction of the Southern Cross constellation, comprising of five white, five-pointed stars. The flag is complicated due mostly to the bird of paradise. Though the drawing is a silhouette and doesn't have highly detailed features, the outline is still complex, and it makes the flag very difficult to draw accurately. The depiction of the Southern Cross adds further complication to the flag, though it's not nearly as difficult as the Bird of Paradise. For this principle, the flag scores 0 out of 10. The flag was adopted in 1971 when Papua New Guinea was going through the process of gaining independence. At the time, it was part of a trusteeship administered by Australia. The flag was designed by Susan Karike, who was a schoolgirl at the time. Her design was based off a proposal submitted by an Australian government worker and artist, Hal Holman. His design was a vertical tricolor which had the Southern Cross and Bird of Paradise charges. The flag was unpopular among the people of Papua New Guinea. Susan's design kept the charges, but the tricolor layout was changed to the diagonal bicolor. She chose red and black because, along with yellow, these colors are used by the people in traditional art and ceremonies. Regarding the symbolism of the charges, the Bird of Paradise is endemic to the island of New Guinea and has long been a traditional emblem. Their feathers are also used in traditional dress and for festivals. It symbolizes Papua New Guinea's emergence as a nation. The Southern Cross constellation reflects the country's connection to Australia and other countries in the South Pacific. It's also believed to refer to a local legend about five sisters. Overall, the flag has good symbolism with a strong focus on the people and their traditions. For this principle, the flag scores 10 out of 10. The flag has four colors. Those are red, black, yellow, and white. That's one color more than the recommended maximum of three. All four colors are part of the standard set. With contrast, we have an issue with the red and black. These are both dark colors which contrast poorly. Thankfully, the light colors of yellow and white for the charges contrast well with the red and black triangles. Overall for color, the flag scores 6.5 out of 10. The flag doesn't have any lettering or seals. The national emblem consists of a bird of paradise. This depiction is far more detailed than the one on the flag. So while part of the flag uses the national emblem, the fact it's a simpler design means it gains some marks, though it still loses a lot of marks because the design on the flag is still rather complicated. For this principle, the flag scores 3 out of 10. The flag is highly distinctive. While the Southern Cross is used on a number of other flags, the Bird of Paradise depiction is unique to this flag. For this principle, the flag scores 10 out of 10. So now we've reviewed the flag on each of the five principles. We're going to add the scores and divide by 5 to get the average. So, for the national flag of Papua New Guinea, we get a final score of 5.9 out of 10.